Don't raise the taxes on the town. Instead, lower the taxes on the village so they're the same as the town, and then everyone will vote for the merger. As long as the town taxes go up and the village taxes go down, it's not going to pass.
Mm-hmm. I've been watching the Democratic format, but I think Bernie has a good chance, even though everybody's saying he doesn't, but I think he has a good chance. So.
Great. So you're here to help him along in that.
Well, actually, I didn't.
Oh, okay.
I'm on the other party.
All right.
But I do. I would if I could.
Go, Bernie.
People fought and died for the right to vote, so I make it out every time there's an opportunity.
I've always been a voter, and I enjoy voting and feel it's my responsibility, and all citizens should do that.
Well, the family gathered. It was my wife's birthday, and so she never allows us to talk about politics, but the Democratic primary is exciting. We were talking about the Essex and Essex Town Select Board, and we all came in knowing what we were going to put on the ballot.
So the reason why I'm voting no and encouraging people to vote no is because the 3+3 charter change is very divisive. It pits the village versus a town instead of asking what could we as a community do to further move our community forward. It creates these divisions that we're trying to move past. Additionally, for today's election, for instance, we have Vince Franco and we have Andy Watts, who are two town residents. In a current proposal, the village wouldn't have anybody to vote for at that point. Additionally, the current five select board members are voted at large, which would mean that I, as a resident, have five options. In this opportunity, I'd only have three. So it's also limiting my representation options. So those are just some of the reasons why.
3+3 is a concept where we'll get rid of at-large voting. At-large voting is a system which can be easily manipulated and taken advantage of. Historically, it has been. It's been used for racial discrimination, all sorts of things which a small majority can totally dominate a town. And we have that problem here. Historically, what's happened in our town is that when the town creates a service that the village already has, the village has to pick up half that tab, even though they already have one of their own. The fire station is the best example, the fire departments. Really not fair. How could that possibly happen? Well, you think the answer is select board domination. So 3+3 will put us on an even footing. Negotiations at a time like that, for example, might have been interesting. The village might have been able to say, well, wait a minute, we need to have some compensation for this situation. We've been covering the town all these years, and now we're going to have to cover half the town fire station. We have our own. An arrangement might have been made, we think. And 3+3 will at least set us up for negotiation.
Two things motivated me. One was the presidential primary, and I'm delighted to have cast my vote for the most qualified candidate. And my other thing is this whole charter issue, and so I wanted to make sure I cast my vote on that because that's our local issue that would affect my representation. So,
what brought me onto the polls is just that I think everybody should vote. I know that the system, a lot of people feel the system is broken, and I don't disagree with that opinion, but I think that the best chance we have is of getting representation that really reflects what people want is getting as many people to the polls as possible. So just wanted to come and put my vote in today as well.
With Trump in office, it's, for me, it's immigration policies, criminal justice reform, and general like equalities like gender equality, LGBTQ rights, like those types of things that I feel like the country is kind of just, I feel like we've stopped caring about them, and I feel like there's a lot of injustices that are happening, maybe not in Vermont, but definitely around the country.